With Udoka Azubuike back, Kansas beat number 5 Clemson on Friday. But after back-to-back Elite Eight exits, can Bill Self's Jayhawks squad finally win one more and reach the Final Four? Omaha, Neb. After the final seconds of Kansas's latest triumph in this NCAA tournament had ticked away, Udoka Azubuike, parked on the bench after picking up his fifth foul with 2:30 left in the second half, stood up, looked out at the jubilant tableau unfolding before him and began clapping. A towel draped over his shoulders and a black brace supporting his left knee, Azubuike dapped up a teammate, senior guard Devante Graham, before entering the handshake line and joining another one, sophomore guard Malik Newman. For interviews on Press Row, Azubuike had just watched his Jayhawks advance to the Elite Eight for the third consecutive year as an 0-1 seed, with an 80-76 win over number 5 seed Clemson that was at once affirming and concerning. Kansas looked like one of the best teams in the field as it racked up 1.15 points per possession by halftime against an elite defense and built a 20-point lead in the second half, only to have Clemson roar back to make it a 4-point game twice, inside the last minute. "We didn't finish the game very well at all," head coach Bill Self said afterward. "We played not to lose late." The operative cliche here is that Kansas survived and advanced. The Jayhawks doing as much as the most important thing, not least because of what they have the potential to do next. The best version of this Kansas team was not available for its three games leading into the tourney, and in the days after Selection Sunday, there was enough doubt about its availability to feed speculation that maybe, just maybe, it would become the first 0-1 to go down in the first round. A different 0-1 claimed that distinction. The Jayhawks thumped the University of Pennsylvania, and now, one win away from the Final Four, they seem to be getting closer to reaching their ceiling as a small ball, floor-spreading offensive machine. At the CenturyLink Center here on Friday night, Kansas brought a swift and convincing end to one of the better stories of these NCAAs, Clemson. The Tigers not only won a pair of games in the tourney, including a thorough 31-point beatdown of 4-seed Auburn, but they did it after earning their first at-large bid since 2011, shaking off rampant hot seat chatter surrounding head coach Brad Brownell as well as a season-ending injury to their best player, senior forward Dante Grantham, and drawing a 13th-place preseason projection in the ACC. The Jayhawks sent home the Tigers because their perimeter-oriented attack is a nightmare to contain when it's whirring at full tilt, and because that attack is even more of a nightmare to contain when Kansas has its primary big man at or close to peak form. A sprained medial collateral ligament had sidelined Azubuike for the Big 12 tournament and limited him to just 3 minutes for Kansas's tourney opener against Penn. After battling through 22 minutes in a second-round win over Seton Hall, he was on the floor against the Tigers for 25 minutes, more than his average in conference play before the injury. "I feel great," Azubuike said afterward, though he conceded that he's not 100% yet. Clemson came into Friday's game with one of the top interior defenses in the country, but like most of the teams Kansas has faced, it did not have an effective counter for Aspre Doak, who establishes position in the paint. Azubuike went to work against shot-blocking ace Elijah Thomas and the rest of Clemson's front line, shrewdly working the post for his own buckets or kickouts to shooters. He scored on rim-shaking dunks and contested turnarounds and crashed the offensive glass, finishing with 14 points on 7 of 9 shooting and 11 boards, good for his sixth double-double of the season. Azubuike held his own defensively, too. A massive frame, listed at 7 foot 280 pounds, and heavy feet make him a liability roaming out to the perimeter, but Azubuike's sheer presence can serve as a deterrent for would-be drivers. Midway through the second half, after Clemson had recorded 5 unanswered points to cut into what was a 20-point Kansas lead, Azubuike shuffled his feet to contain Tigers guard Marquise Reed off the dribble before leaping to swat his layup attempt off the backboard, igniting a fast break that led to a transition wing 3 from Graham. "Just his presence alone," Graham said of Azubuike, "you can't duplicate it." What Azubuike did to propel Kansas to the regional finals against No. 2 seed Duke was not a total surprise. Self had given notice that Azubuike would be fit to put in a full day's work. At a news conference on Thursday, he was asked about how Azubuike performed in workouts the previous week. "He's been fine," Self said. "He practiced full speed Tuesday, Wednesday. We'll practice today.